Welcome back to Miss Red Dragon 543, and today we are continuing our adventure. God damn, that's so chewy. With Lego Star Wars Force Awakens. So last time we completed whatever the hell we were on last time. Yeah. So we just gotta beat up these Rhinox here. Mind you, Chewie can also blow these stuff up. So yeah, there's a gold brick here. We might as well just get since we're here.
Not quite.
The hyperdrive took a knock and the jumper needs realigning. Think you can handle that?
Yeah. Alright, so we just gotta go find this. Yeah, some stuff you can just get on the way since you're gonna be there anyways.
There's spares and some crates around there if you need them.
Too bad you can't really
can you realign and
detonate
the,
bombs as you wish. But yeah. Oops.
Hey, that's it. Nice work. The Navi computer should be operational.
Yeah, so I find it interesting. Sure, so I know a lot of people are talking about the whole Joe Rogan situation, which I find really funny because he was talking about like how to him he feels that gaming is useless. But I find it funny. I guess the way he said it, it kind of pissed off people. Because they felt that it was very insulting. Now, what I gotta say is that a lot of people, you know, there's definitely some reasons why gaming can be difficult for people to get, like, jobs for. Like, sometimes you need charisma. Sometimes you need, a personality that people can definitely enjoy, and there's also a certain energy that people need to kind of conspire. So it's also kind of give and take, right? So we give the energy, the entertainment, as you know, the people give us the views and the likes and subscribes, whatever. However, one thing I also gotta say too is like when he was talking about the whole jiu-jitsu thing and saying like that the problem with jiu-jitsu and sports and stuff is it's not 100% guaranteed that you will wind up getting what you need, because the problem with what he was kind of saying, which I think was definitely misinterpreted, was he was saying it as if it was a guaranteed thing that like if you do these things for all these years, you'll wind up getting pretty much a position automatically. That's
I'm just a scavenger.
I don't know why he made it sound like that. It was just very bizarre, but I see why like people didn't found it very distasteful why Joe Rogan said that. But
why did he leave?
What do you guys think about the whole Joe Rogan situation? Do you think he kind of just jumped in a little too far, got carried away with what he was thinking? Or do you think it was just more the matter of fact that like it was just his own personal experience that he was just thinking about? You know, like there are some people, I want to say this now, there are some people that play horribly at video games and they have a sustainable career. I just want you to think about that for a second. You know, it's really ironic that there are people like that, right? So.
Solo, why are we here again?
Get your droid on a clean ship.
Alright, yeah, so you got a blue, a red brick over here. We just gotta kill these back here. Where are they?
You trust her, right?
Relax, kid. She's run this watering hole for 1,000 years.
Alright. Yeah, so this is Maz's castle. It's very interesting how this is also a very shorter level. Or not a shorter level, like there's... It's one of the levels which doesn't really have enemies in it, per se. Like, I find it interesting because a lot of LEGO games are like that nowadays, where it's like there's levels in them which don't really have that much to offer per se, but it's just very interesting, right? Yeah, kick that. Oops, sorry, not trying to kill you. Yeah. So I do find it interesting that Joe Rogan was talking about the whole like gaming thing and stuff, and like, I found it interesting when people got pretty angry because it's like, I can see why, but also at the same time, there's definitely a lot of misinformation going around with a lot of things, so it's just more like, it's kind of like how journalism in gaming, they are not always right. And they got a lot of information wrong. But then again, all journalism likes to, you know, clickbait situations, which is not healthy. And I think that's one of the issues, is just the fact that there's a lot of clickbait, right? Where's the other freak? There we go. There's one. Alright. Yeah, just remember, I am trying to get, like, all the red bricks and stuff, all the mini kits and just playthrough. So I am making it 100% playthrough, so that way people who are stuck can actually, like, follow along. So I say, watch, you know, like, once this whole series comes out, you know, watch both, like, part one, part two. Or, like, once it gets to the free roam stuff, I will, I'll pretty much make it so that way, like, people can actually, like, go back to this video to see what mini kits they're missing. Because there's mini kits you can get on the first run, and then mini kits you can get on the second run. So it's just a matter of like when you can get them, because I know sometimes, especially for the flying and dog segments or the dog fights, you can wind up getting most of the mini kits right away, which is not bad, you know. It's gonna Hadouken. Yeah, so we need Ray, who's got that ability to wall climb. And if you can see Ray the way, there's a minikit right here. That's one thing I kind of do like, is the fact that there is like minikits that you can just kind of get right away, kind of thing, so that way you can make it more easier for yourself.
Nothing wakes you up like a face full of water.
I don't know, I wouldn't wake up people that way, but yeah. Yeah, this is the weirdest level. But I do find it weird how the one scene that Ray starts using the blaster, it's not working out for her, which is kind of ironic. Because you'd think that the gun would be important in some form, but I guess not. Alright. Get my soccer ball.
Hmm. much of a morning person, are you?
Moz is a bit of an acquired taste, so let me...
Yeah. So I do want to know that as well, like, what is your favorite aspect of LEGO games, if you do enjoy LEGO games?
Hey, Moz.
You know?
I assume you need something. Desperately.
Moz, I need you to get this droid to Leia.
No. You've been running away from this fight for too long.
What fight?
Against the dark side. Through the ages, I've seen evil take many forms. The Sith, the Empire. Today, it is the First Order.
There is no fight against the First Order. Not one we can win. We all need to run.
You see those two? They'll trade work for transportation to the Outer Rim. There, you can disappear.
I'm not resistance. I'm not a hero.
Finn.
There was so much potential for Finn and Rey, but like, it's kind of sad to see that they had so much potential, but it's just the rating that lets them down. Bar fight. Yeah, there's a purple. All right. I think I can shoot that chicken. Nope. Oh, okay. I guess that was for the purple stud, which I already got. Yeah, so you do get a trophy for like missing 10 times on purpose. It's like I think like aim of stormtrooper or something. Can't remember if you can do this again for a minikit,
okay,
but...
Okay, sure. I'll follow you someplace.
I guess not. Gotta collect them studs, baby! Did he just slide? Alright. Yeah, like I said, Maz's castle is a very more smaller level. I wonder if I can shoot that. It's always good to get the studs, like I said, because the more studs we can get, the more we can quickly get the score time stuff, and the better we get the score time stuff. I thought there was a thing over here. Yeah, so this also has three parts. There's this part, and then Ray goes down in the basement, I believe. I'm just destroying everything because it's funny. Or fun. Okay. All I know is I cannot wait for LEGO Star Wars the Skywalker Saga. I hope that they keep the Yoda and R2-D2 death sounds, because those were peak LEGO. Like, they were pretty fucking funny. I liked it. Alright, Maz over here is like, hey, what are you doing? Stop. Yeah, okay. Let's kill these guys, why not? Alright, so we need... I like how quick interact is a good thing. Alright, so now we just gotta shoot this. Motherfucker. Get back over there. Oh, there we go.
I've always said that there's nothing that won't fix itself if you just ignore it for long enough.
That's not how things work.
I guess I can spare a few minutes.
Who's the girl?
Or it's been a while. Yeah, so Azra, you want to go back here?
I don't know where I'm going. Or why. It's just an old droid. It can't hurt us.
That's pretty funny. Oh yeah, there's these spiders up here, so you want to get those spider webs. As you can see. Yeah, so once you get the floor.
Yeah, they look like they could hurt us though.
Alright, so. Alright. How the hell do you miss? And sometimes it's weird how the auto aim, or like not the auto aim, but sometimes even the manual aim will have issues, which is really dumb.
You can open that door, right?
I'm just gonna open this quickly. Oh yeah. Excuse
me. You can open that door, right?
You can open this door, right? Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. I don't know why, so there's a few things that they added to this game which I thought was weird. One of them being...
It's just more old droids. We're not turning back.
Because I, like I said, I guess like, no.
Although I'd be open to persuasion.
Oh, what is it? So there's all this interesting stuff. Where is... Isn't there not a cobweb area in here? The droid is with us. Okay, so...
What do you think that did?
Oh, that's annoying. I don't know why those buttons are very finicky like that. It's weird. So I haven't seen no spiderweb in this area. I'm surprised. Okay. So it must be two more in the other area unless I got it. Bam. Yeah, so for the new Star Wars game that's coming out too, so apparently I'm hearing October or possible November release. I do find it interesting how one of the things that I am hearing as well is that they're having a stronger emphasis on combat. So like for instance, like I guess square will be light attack, triangle will be heavy attack, circle will be like your force abilities, and I guess like they'll have like the shooting systems. I guess I found it really weird that they're introducing that, but I found it pretty funny too, because it's just really interesting, right, that they're doing this whole system. Okay. So I'm just gonna make sure that... Yeah, so I'm gonna pay attention. I don't know what this does. Okay. Okay. So we just need to collect the cogs.
That's part of it.
All right, now I'm just gonna. Yeah, this is one of the more oddly difficult puzzles for some reason. I'm not too sure why. I guess it's also because it's pretty dark in here that it's harder to see where the puzzles are, but eh. Oh, okay, never mind. I just realized. I'm sitting here like, what am I doing wrong here? Very interesting puzzle. It's a very smart puzzle, but a very interesting puzzle. I still remember one of my favorite, so I play on the DS, and it's interesting because there's one game on the DS that a lot of people don't really like. Which I was kind of surprised about, because it was, Zelda, Phantom Hourglass. And there's always this one puzzle I actually thought was pretty neat. And I guess how, in the puzzle, how it worked is, So I guess for the puzzle, what you did is, essentially, you had to close the DS like a book in order to copy a print on a map, which I thought was a pretty cool idea. There's a lot of cool ideas that like the DS utilized, such as the blowing mechanic and stuff, which I thought was pretty neat too. Okay. I'm still unsure how the hell to even open that. Like, is there a certain thing that I need? I'm just trying to think because there's like this door down here. Like, do I need to use the force, I guess?
That should be it now, BB-8. That's it. That's the symbol.
That's the symbol of truth.
Whatever it is, it's close.
Okay. Like how there's all this like treasure and shit. Hey, it's the Ark from Indiana Jones. It's the knights who say nee.
Quiet girl. Quiet girl. Us now. Shushit. There's no place like home. One quarter portion.
Really? Ray? Fucking Dorothy. One quarter portion.
That lightsaber was Luke's, and his father's before him, and now it calls to you.
I have to get back to Jack.
Dear child, I see your eyes. The belonging you seek is not behind you. It is ahead. The saber. Take it.
I'm never touching that thing again. I don't want any part of this.
Today is the end of the Republic. This fierce machine which you have built, upon which we stand,
probably me out of fucking
systems will bow to the First Order.
Do 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 do. Gold brick. True Jedi. One, two, three, four, five, five minigames. Re, Tokogana, Bazin, Carternus, Grabgar. Oh, fucking hell. Crusty. Continue. See what.
I have to get back to Jakku. I need a ship.